The concept of getting into a hollow tube and flying up into the air is too much to bear for some people. It will literally scare them to death. And by hollow tube, I mean airplane. But for others, it's not the flying up in the air part that's scary. It's the coming back down and landing on the ground part. Welcome back to Nexus. Today we're going to be going over 5 of the most dangerous airports in the whole world. If you guys enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If we can aim for 3,000 likes, well, we'll make a part 2 to this video because there are some pretty scary airports in the world that we can't necessarily fit into this video. Also, be sure to let us know down below in the comments. Have you ever flown into these airports before? If so, how was your experience? Number 5, Lukla, Nepal. The Lukla Airport in Nepal serves as the main airport for those wanting to visit Mount Everest. So not only does it require a lot of courage to climb to the summit of Mount Everest, but it also requires a lot of courage to land at this airport to get to where you need to go to summit Mount Everest. So you're really knocking out 2 birds with 1 stone and cross those off your list if you want to climb Mount Everest. And part of what makes this airport so difficult to navigate and land in is how it's nestled in between mountains and the incredibly short length of the runway. In fact, the whole terminal is quite small in and of itself. There's no lights on the airport or on the runway, and there's little electric power, so landing in anything other than perfect conditions becomes even riskier. And to make matters worse, guess what? There's also no air traffic control towers on the site or controllers, meaning that the pilots in the airplane are on their own to touch down in these sometimes larger aircrafts. It's also one of the highest airports in the world that you can find. So you better hope for one that you're not on a large aircraft that requires a long runway to land. And you also better hope that your pilot knows a little bit about what they're doing. Number 4, Princess Juliana International Airport in St. Martin. So like other runways in the Caribbean Sea, Princess Juliana Airport, which is located in St. Martin, is perhaps the most famous airport in this video. It's most notable for its public beach situated just below the runway. This placement often results in large and loud gusts of wind and sand blowing up into those trying to enjoy these crystal blue waters. For the pilots, hitting these tourists is the least of their worries. But there is one thing to worry about with this airport, and that's that the runway is incredibly short. It's 2,100 meters long. And like I said, that's very short considering the large aircrafts that are landing on this runway require more than 2,500 meters of runway to ensure a safe landing. Yeah, they can make it, but you better hope your pilots are pretty experienced with this. And the reason for this is because the Princess Juliana Airport and runway was initially just built for smaller airplanes, but because of the booming tourist industry and the amount of people wanting to come here, this place has attracted tons of bigger airplanes like Boeing 747s and many others into the regular traffic rotation. Number 3. Paro Airport in the Bhutan Himalayan Mountains. So that right there between the Himalayan Mountains is enough to make me never want to go to this airport or this area or have to land there without driving in a car. So this airport is continuously ranked as one of the most dangerous airports in the world. And what's even crazier, aside from this thing being very short, this runway, and also being situated between a bunch of mountains, is that only 8 pilots in the whole world are qualified to land on this airstrip. The runway is surrounded by 5,500 meter peaks with the runway of only 2,000 meters long. And remember what I said before about bigger aircrafts needing more than 2,500 meters of runway to ensure a safe landing? Well, this doesn't have that. It doesn't have a lot of things that would make me want to land here. Have you guys ever landed here before? Let me know down below. If so, how was that experience? I am genuinely curious. Due to the fast descent that larger planes need to make the approach to this strip, many rank it as the most dangerous airport in the whole wide world. Number 2, Gibraltar International Airport. So this is probably the most extreme airport in South Europe. So this runway isn't particularly hard to land on, but it has an interesting design feature that makes it incredibly dangerous. There was a huge design flaw with this runway here. So do you guys remember those games like Cross the Road or that Frog Crossing Road game where you play as a frog and you got to cross the road to get to the other side, but you've got all these cars in the way trying to run you over. Well, that's essentially the concept with this runway, because the main street of this area, Winston Churchill Avenue, fitting name, intersects the runway and it has to be closed when a plane needs to land. There's a stoplight on the road telling cars to stop, but there have actually been a number of close calls in this airport's history, which is just insane. There is a main roadway running in the middle of this runway. Why would you do that? That's some stuff out of a Final Destination movie. You don't put a road going through a runway. I've never even seen that in a video game. Number one, Narcissuric Airport, Greenland. This is one of the most extreme airports in the whole wide world. It's constantly covered in ice almost every month of the year. At only 1,800 meters and canvassed in slick ice, this runway is the most difficult in the world for just about any pilot. It doesn't matter how experienced you are. The weather is constantly storming, creating intense turbulence and low visibility on approach, making it the worst airport in the world for both flight staff as well as passengers. And I always heard a saying, you shouldn't worry on an airplane unless you see the flight attendants worrying, because these men and women know when to worry, they know what's normal, and they know what isn't normal. Sheer winds affect planes, which coupled with the icy runway can direct them off of course, make it hard to see to land, and to top that off, there's a nearby active volcano that commonly erupts, sending ash into the clouds, which is bad for airplanes for many reasons. A couple of those is that the ash can stall and destroy engines. And the time of landing is also one of these things that you have to consider when coming to this place. So nope, nope, and nope. Don't think I'm ever going to go to this airport, and at least I hope I don't have to. With that said, that's our list of the top 5 most dangerous airports in the world. As I said at the beginning of the video, if we can aim and reach that like goal of 3,000 likes, then I promise we'll make a part 2 to this video, because there are tons of dangerous airports scattered throughout the world. Also, don't forget to subscribe and turn on those notifications. That way you guys never miss out on another Nexus upload. And with that said, thank you all for stopping by and have a great day.